Hi, thanks for joining me. I'm going to work on a limited palette painting today. And I'm starting by just prepping my canvas, using a 16 by 20 canvas, by the way, but prepping my canvas with a mixture of titanium white and linseed oil, and just getting a smooth, even coat on the canvas. You can see I've got some paint in front of you right now, and what I've done is taken some ultramarine blue, mixed it with some Van Dyke brown, and got a pretty dark color, actually almost a black color. And I picked up a 2-inch brush, and I'm starting to put that paint mixture on the canvas, just working it in right now, maybe concentrating on getting some light areas and some dark areas, and just see how it goes. Intentionally leaving some areas lighter and some areas darker, and it makes for a more interesting sky instead of just one solid color. You get some variation, gives you more things to look at. Only working with one camera today, so I may miss a few angles here, but I'm trying to hold it up so you can see how I'm mixing my colors. I'm loading my fan brush up with that mixture, and I'm going to drop in a few trees here. And you can see how I'm holding my brush. And really what's important here is just getting the tree shape correct. You don't have to worry about individual branches so much, but just start very, very, very small up the top, and as you come down, let the tree kind of widen out. And I'll put several in this painting. And I vary them, some tall, some short, some light, some dark. And we'll do several here so you can kind of get an idea how I do them. And notice just dabbing it in. When I turn my brush, minute ago, you probably couldn't see what I was doing, but I'm just filling in the center so you can't see a tree trunk running all the way down from top to bottom. So I tap on one side, tap on the other, and then also tap a little bit in the center. Notice that the bristles are kind of folding up as I do this. Once you get it down, you can move fairly quickly when you make your trees. Not that you need to be in a hurry, but sometimes the faster you go, the better they look, because they look a little bit more natural. They don't have to be perfect. I'll do several, putting a bigger one here in the center. I use the center part of my fan brush just to get kind of a guiding line. You can see that I'm working with there, just to know where to start, and it also gives me the very top of the tree where there's no branches at all, and then I can move down from there. I'm making a little darker one here, maybe it's a little bigger, a little closer, or just a little closer so it appears a little darker. Often picking up a 1-inch brush now, and I'm going to tap out the base of these colors, and when I say tap out, I'm just going to kind of really smudge the paint away, and it gives kind of a misty effect at the base of the trees. It moves them back in your painting, gives the illusion that they're farther away from you. Notice that the brush moves up and down a little as I tap. I'm not going across in a straight line, because if you do that, well, you end up with a straight line showing up in your painting, and you don't want that to happen. Letting the paint flow out away from where I did the trees, just to let a little paint smear across there. And put a little darker paint on my brush now, and we'll tap in some distant, you know, bushes or trees or that sort of thing. More of a deciduous type of a tree instead of an evergreen. But these are really kind of non-distinct here. It kind of frames it in too. places, some shore places, a little dark, a little light in some places. Pick up my 2-inch brush again, now that I've got the background misted out, and I'm going to start brushing in a landmass here. You could use really any size brush to do this, but I'm just using a 2-inch to get the paint on the canvas fairly quickly, and it makes for a pretty smooth brush stroke as well. You could use a fan brush or any number of different types of brushes to do this, but the smaller the brush you use when you're in a large amount of paint, the more choppy the paint will appear on you, the more brush strokes you'll have, that kind of thing. Brushing in some what's going to be water now, so I'm brushing straight down and then lightly brushing across, and it gives kind of a shimmer effect to the paint. And this is a good way to make something appear to look like water. And just working in my landmass a little bit more. Just using one color here, just that dark blue and brown mixture, and sometimes putting a little bit of titanium white in it to lighten it up, but right now I'm just using that straight mixture with no white added. I want it fairly dark starting out. Now, I know this looks odd. You're thinking, how's this going to be snow up here in the front? But it will be. Just adding more up the 1-inch brush, and you see how I'm loading it, just kind of tapping into the paint, and then I'm tapping on the canvas, and I'm tapping, I'm not brushing, I'm just putting some darker bushes kind of in the mid ground there, right in front of those evergreen, those background trees I painted. If you make it a little darker, it appears to be closer in the canvas. Of course, as you move from the top of the canvas downward, things appear closer as you move downward in the canvas, on the canvas. Picking up my palette knife. And trying to decide where I want to put in a cabin. I'm going to do a cabin. Just kind of, well, you can see I'm just working it in here. I'd rather make it a little bit small initially, and then I can go back and make it larger if I need to. So if I'm going to make any type of mistake on this, I'd rather err on the conservative side and make it a little bit too small. It's a lot easier to make it bigger than it is to make it too big and try to make it smaller. Make it bigger, I just have to add more paint. To make it smaller, it would involve me having to scrape away some paint. Could end up with a mess on my hands if I do that. Just taking my time here. Working on the front of the building, starting out. Just trying to square it up a little bit better, get my perspective. And you'll notice I'm putting the roof on now, and if your building that you're painting, your cabin, your barn, whatever you're doing, is to appear to be moving away from you, you need to put a little bit of slant on your roof from front to back. So you notice that my roof appears to be slanting downward from front to back ever so slightly, and that gives the illusion that the cabin, the back part of the cabin's farther away from you. And a lot of beginners make the mistake of drawing, you know, the roof straight across, or even having it tilted up from front to back. And if you do that, it looks like the cabin's falling toward you. So I like to slant it downward a lot of the times, and it just makes your perspective look right. Loaded my knife with some titanium white. I'm just putting some highlights on the roof, just short little knife strokes, and letting a little bit of paint pull off of the knife at a time. Notice how I'm holding the knife, by the way. I've got my index finger and my thumb on it, but notice that my index finger really isn't up on the knife blade at all. If you put your index finger up on the knife blade, it makes the knife tilt forward, and it makes it very difficult to get the paint off the knife onto the canvas. And again, just taking my time here, trying to do some highlights, not getting in a hurry. I'm going to put a few highlights on the edge of the cabin now with the titanium white. Decide from which direction your light source is coming and then highlight accordingly. So in this particular painting, we're going to assume that the light source is coming from the left. I just scraped away some paint there in the center, and then I'm going to put in some just the straight dark mixture there in the middle, just to put a door. Add a little titanium white to the small edge of my knife and highlight a couple edges of the door just to make it stand out a little bit. So you see it kind of frames it in. And I'll put a little side shed on this cabin. I do that on a lot of my buildings, just makes it a little bit more interesting. Again, going back with some titanium white on the knife and highlighting on the left-hand side, letting it fade as I move to the right. And I do that by just letting the paint get used up on my knife as I move from left to right. There's less and less paint on the knife, so it actually just naturally fades. So I'm going to scrape away at the bottom here. Notice at the front of the cabin toward the back at the bottom, it tends to slant upward. So again, it gives the illusion that the cabin is moving away from you. In other words, the back part of the cabin is farther away from you. And now I picked up my fan brush. I'm going to brush in a little snow underneath this cabin to kind of set it in so it doesn't look like it's floating in the air there. Just putting a little snow around it. Paying attention to the slope of my land, not sloping it too drastically, just letting it flow here. You could put it on a steeper hillside if you wanted, but I don't like to make it too crazy. Just raking a little white in there to make it look like snow. Frame my cabin in somewhat by putting a large tree in here. And this is the straight dark mixture, no white in it at all. In order to make the tree appear closer in the painting, I'll drop it down a little farther down in the painting. Set it right there next to the cabin. Very dark paint, and a little lower in the painting. Notice I'm dropping down a little lower than those trees in the background, setting it right down there on the land. Going back in and just filling in a little bit in the center. And we'll put one right next to it, a little smaller. I try not to do them all the same height. Get some variation in your painting. Makes it much more interesting. Makes it very interesting to look at. If they're all the same height, it actually ends up looking a little bit odd. And balance it out somewhat by putting some trees on the other side. So lots of trees in this painting. This would be a good practice painting to learn how to paint trees. And once you do that, picking up a clean 2-inch brush you can see there, and I'm gonna kind of pull the paint down very lightly though. Notice how I'm holding the brush. Just lightly there, and then lightly across just to give kind of a shimmer effect. So it kind of dulls it down a little bit and sits it into the water a little. Picking up my palette knife again, and I'm gonna use that just to put the snow. Using titanium white, of course, but the snow on the bank a little heavier. If you use the knife, of course, you can really drop it in there. If you use a brush, sometimes the brush will mix with the paint underneath and you end up making a mess. You gotta be careful. Again, look at how I'm holding the knife. Index finger and thumb on the sides of the knife. That way you can kind of hold the knife flat against the canvas and get that paint off. If you have too much of an angle, the paint won't come off. You'll end up scraping paint off the canvas rather than putting paint on. So I'm just shaping it here some. Remember I started with that very dark paint underneath, but look at it now. It's starting to look like snow. You got to have darks as well as lights when you're painting snow. You can't just do straight white. You got to have shadows. Just picked up a filbert brush. I'm gonna load it up with the dark blue brown mixture. And I'm loading one side of the brush. Now on the other side, I'm gonna go just pick up some of that. I got some titanium white here. It's kind of dirty, but I'm gonna load one side with white. I'm gonna do the white side up and the dark side down, and just kind of twisting my wrist there and paint some rocks in the water. Now you got to be careful. You don't want these all the same size. You don't want them arched up too tall. They'll end up like turtles or snail shells in the water or something like that. So we're painting them in. Right now they look like they're floating on the water. So what we'll have to do at some point here in a minute is drop some reflection into the water so it makes it look like they're actually sitting in the water rather than floating on top of it. Picked up my 1-inch brush and I'm pulling some paint down to get some reflection in the water now. And again, brushing across just to give a little bit of a shimmer. And we'll sit them down in the water. I'm going to drop a little bit of a water line in just using my palette knife with a little of that titanium white underneath the rocks. Splash underneath the rocks or a little bit of a water line, and again it sits them in the water as opposed to making them look like they're floating on the water. And some more little water lines, ripples, what have you. Or reflections of light, whatever you want to call it. Just working in a little more snow. I'm going to go back in with my filbert brush. And I thought a little bit of stark down there in that left hand corner, so I thought maybe I'd drop a tree limb across here. I've got white on one part of the knife and dark, or excuse me, white on one part of the brush and then dark on the other part. I'm just going to drop in a like a tree branch or something that's fallen across there. Just detailing that a little bit, a few tree branches here and there. Don't get it too crazy looking. You don't want it to be a distraction. You want it to add to the painting, but you don't want it to be a distraction. So I'm gonna do too much on it. And since I'm using that liner brush, I can get a fine line with a fine point. Maybe put in a few dead trees and sticks and twigs in the background just to fill in some gaps. And I'll take my liner brush, and a lot of times I'll take it and just kind of spin it in the paint, and it'll allow you to get a pretty good point on your brush. So just a few places here and there. Decided to go back here and detail the tree a little bit more across here, the limb. Maybe a few more branches. It looks like a good place for a fence back here. Again, still using the liner brush. Notice that I have the fence. It's taller toward the barn or the cabin. As it moves away from the cabin, the posts appear to get smaller. It's because they're moving out across the field and back here toward the trees. So we'll give the illusion that it's moving away from us. We'll drop it on the other side of the cabin as well. Maybe I can fit a couple of fence posts in there. And steadying my hand here. You really can't see what I'm doing. You notice I grabbed the side of the canvas so I can steady my hand. I'm painting a few little birds there, just the, kind of M-shaped. Unfortunately, I don't have a good angle on the camera here, but I start where the body would be, and I brush outward away from the body to do the wings. You can see them there. Higher up they are in the canvas. I know this is going to sound kind of odd, but the higher, because you're in the sky, the higher up they are in the canvas, the closer they will appear to you. So if you drop down in the canvas toward the horizon, the birds would appear smaller. Now I'm painting in it. Since I've got that liner brush, I'm going to paint in a little chimney here on my cap. Okay, so I got a little titanium white on here. Picked up another small, it's not really a liner brush, but it's a little small round brush. And I'm going to put in a little titanium white, make it look like some smoke coming out of that cabin. Out of the chimney, anyhow. And you just got to put it in there and take your time. Don't get too carried away. And with that, I think we'll call this one a finished painting. Hope you enjoyed the video today. And remember to stop back and see me again. Keep painting.